vector A and B. Suppose there are two vectors A and B, vector A and vector B. Cross product of vector A and vector B is another vector C. Okay, if we are taking the product of two vectors using cross or vector, then its result will be get in vector form, and this will be C. Okay, whose magnitude, its magnitude C, whose magnitude is equal to the this vector C, magnitude is equal to product of magnitude of two vectors, product of magnitude of two vectors means A and B, and sine of smaller angle between them, sine of smaller angle between them. So in mathematically you can write this thing, vector A cross vector B is equal to magnitude of vector A, magnitude of vector B, sine theta. And one thing you have to remember here, C cap is also there. C cap is the resultant of these two vectors. This C has some direction also. Okay, this shows the direction also, and you can write this all term like this, C vector. Okay, this gives you the only magnitude of this, magnitude value of this, and this C cap gives you the direction. Okay, this is the, this thing gives you the magnitude, this gives you the direction, and by these two things a vector is formed. A vector is formed those who have magnitude as well as direction. So this thing becomes a vector when C cap is there. Otherwise, this thing gives you only the magnitude value of this. Okay? So vector A, vector B is equal to vector C, and vector C have the direction. That's why in this formula you have put down C cap. C cap means the resultant direction is there. Okay, no doubt is here. Now, how calculate, very very main concept in the physics, there are two rules with the help of which you can determine the direction. One is right hand Sacrio rule. Right hand Sacrio rule. Or next is right hand thumb rule. Both things are same. What is it mean? How can you explain this thing by this? In this, if you want to determine the direction of C, its resultant vector A, vector, then you have to design something in your mind. Suppose this is a plane, this board is a plane, and you have two vectors here, suppose this is vector A and this is vector B. Okay. At a common point, there are two vectors, vector A, vector B. Now, where C? Where is C? This is the angle between them, theta, A and B. Now, what cross product you want? A cross B or B cross A? It is a very, very good thing. If you want vector A cross vector B, then look at this thing. I am using my right hand now. In right hand, take your thumb at this point from where these vectors are connected. Okay, take thumb in this direction, right hand. Okay, and curl your finger or move your these fingers from A to B, is there? Okay, like this. If you are moving your right hand finger A to B, then this thumb show you the direction of C. Direction of C means upward. In this case, vector C in upward direction. Now the same thing is, suppose B is here, A is here. Now, where the direction of resultant, where the direction of C, then A to B. Turn your finger from A to B. Then this right hand thumb gives you the direction of C. In this way you can take the direction of C. Now, what is right hand screw rule? What is right hand thumb rule? Thumb rule is this, but screw rule is what? For screw, you know, screw is like this. Rings are there on this. This is upper portion of screw. How it works? You know about its rotation. There are two types of rotation of screw. If you have pen, you can see. On pen also, which have rings on that, this screw. Suppose a screw is here like this. A screw is here like this. And you are rotating this A to B in this way, clockwise direction. In this way, clockwise. A to B, then what you are feeling here? We are feeling here, this screw goes into the board. This screw goes into the board. When we are rotating it from A to B, means in clockwise direction. If screw is rotating in clockwise direction, then we are feeling here, this screw is goes into the plane. So this feeling of screw, which is moving inside the plane in the board, gives you the direction of C. Direction of C means while moving A to B, if we are taking cross product A cross B, then vector is in n. But if we are going from B to A, now rotate this screw in anti-clockwise direction. Then what you are feeling now? This screw goes in outward direction, moving towards you. Moving towards you. Okay. Now this gives you the again direction of T, which is outward. Which is outward. You can feel, you can observe, you can do this thing at your home also. So both the rules have the same meaning. This is the rule which is used for cross product of two vectors. In this, you have to know only these things, which vector is in the first position and which one is in the second position. You have to go from first to second, moving your finger from first to second, either this, either that, doesn't matter. This thumb gives you the direction of C always. Okay. Now the next thing is geometrical interpretation. Geometrical interpretation of vector or vector product. What is the meaning of vector product? One is this. Observe how can you take this thing. For this, firstly, heading geometrical interpretation of vector product, not only for vector product of two vectors. Now let us take two vectors A and B. Suppose this point is N, this is Q, this is O. Okay. ON and OQ, there are two vectors A and B. Now we are taking here A cross B. We want to know what is the geometrical meaning of this thing. What is A cross B? What is the meaning of this? You know that A cross B can be written as AB sine theta if you are taking its magnitude, because T cap is ignored when magnitude is there. There is no need of direction in this case. Now we are taking magnitude of this. For geometrical meaning, we are taking this thing, magnitude. There is no requirement of direction. AB sine theta we can write here. Now, what is AB? AB is what is A? A magnitude is ON. So OP, because in your notes, OP is there, not ON. Take this thing OP. Fine. Very simple thing is this, only from here construct something. I am drawing a perpendicular on OP from point Q. Take this point N. And one thing is also there, I am preparing a parallelogram with the help of this pipe. Hello. Look at this thing. Here this diagonal divides this parallelogram in two parts. One is OPQ triangle, another is PQS. Both parts have the same area. Now in this part, this QN is perpendicular. This QN is perpendicular. Now take here in right angle triangle, O and Q, what is the value of sine theta? Take from there sine theta value. Sine theta is what? Perpendicular upon hypotenuse. What is perpendicular here? Perpendicular is QN and hypotenuse is OQ. Now, from here, perpendicular upon hypotenuse. This is perpendicular QN and this is hypotenuse OQ sine theta QN. Okay? QN is equal to OQ sine theta. Cross multiply it. You can get OQ sine theta. Now put this thing in this relation. We can get OP, OQ sine theta will become QN. Now what is OP and QN? OP is this vector, QN is this perpendicular, and this is a triangle. See this triangle only. This thing is used for base and this thing you can use for perpendicular. So here this is base, this is work as base, and this is as perpendicular. This is base and perpendicular. If we are multiplying this thing by 2 and divide by 2, then no effect on it. We can do this thing. Now, this is base. This is perpendicular upon 2. Half of perpendicular and base product is called area of triangle. Area of triangle. Which triangle is this? OPQ. Okay? And this 2 is remaining part. This 2 is remaining part. So you can write this thing 2 into area of triangle OPQ. Okay, you can write in this way. Now vector A cross vector B magnitude is equal to 2 into area of triangle OPQ. Now, what is the meaning of double of area of triangle OPQ? OPQ. If we are taking its double, this gives you the area of this parallelogram. Now, this thing you can write here, area of parallelogram. Which parallelogram is this? OPSQ. So, what we can conclude here, the magnitude of vector product of two vectors, hence magnitude of cross product of two vectors gives area of parallelogram. Area of parallelogram. Okay? In this way, it is the significance, you can say, or geometrical interpretation of two vectors. Now the next thing is, what happens when two vectors are parallel or anti-parallel? What happens if or when two vectors are parallel or anti-parallel? Then what is the cross product of that? Suppose a vector is in x direction, parallel or anti-parallel. Suppose a vector moves in a x axis, another vector is also moved in a x axis, then cross product of these two vectors, we can say I in cross I, or you can say J cross J, if both vectors are moving along y axis, suppose along z axis, k cap cross theta, then theta will be zero here. Theta will be zero or 180 degree we can say. Now apply the logic here. I cap magnitude sine 0 degree or 180 degree you can put here. Sine zero value or sine 180 value is zero. All terms gives you zero. In this way, this becomes zero and this also becomes zero. So one thing is there. If I cross I is there, J cross J is there, K cross K is there, then the result will be zero in cross product. If one vector is perpendicular to another, then theta equal to 90 degree. Theta equal to 90 degree. And in this situation, suppose one vector along x-axis and another vector along y-axis, I cross J we are taking here, then its result will be at T, means in Z direction. Suppose this is x-axis, this is y-axis. If we are rotating our finger from X to Y, then you can take its result in, yes, towards you, and this is positive Z axis, that's why we are taking K. But if reverse is there, not from I to J, if J to I is there, if we are taking J cross I, then we have to move our finger in this way, and then the thumb direction is inward, and in this situation you have to take minus k cap, because in inverse the value of z axis is negative, in outward z axis is positive. This is x positive, this is y positive, this is z positive, this is x negative, this is y negative, and inward there is z negative. Remember this thing. In this way, if we are taking k cross i, suppose k cross i, where k, k is positive, I is positive, I positive is here, k is positive in front of you. Now curl your finger from k to I in this way. In this way you have to go. Now result will be in J. Okay. Suppose I cross K is there. Then do this thing. I cross K. I is there. K is there. Now curl your finger in this way. Rotate your finger in this way. Now the thumb is inward. Minus y means minus j cap is the answer. Okay. In this way, you can take the direction of this product. Now, few examples are there. There are some quantity which are very very important role, which have a very very important role in physics. One is torque. The formula is torque is R cross S. Remember this thing, note down. This is angular momentum. Cross product of these two vectors is also a vector. Angular momentum R cross P, position vector into linear momentum. Position vector into force. Next is velocity. Angular velocity into position vector. Acceleration, angular acceleration into position. Remember these formulas. All are vector products and their resultant you can see here. The resultant is also a vector. This is not a z, this is tau. In this way you can write this way. Now the next thing is, how can you take the cross product magnitude? One of you can take the magnitude of cross product using this formula AB sin theta. But this is useful when magnitude of A and B is given and theta is given. If suppose theta is not given, A and B magnitude is not given, magnitude you can take. Suppose vector A value is 2i minus 3j plus 4k cap. Can you take its magnitude? In simple way, you can take its magnitude. How? For magnitude, you have to do square of the coefficient of I plus square the coefficient of j minus 3 square plus square the coefficient of k, that is plus 4 square, and whole under root. In this way you can take the magnitude of any vector. Now 2 square is 4 plus minus 3 square is plus 9, and this will be 16. 25, 39 under the root is the magnitude of this vector you can take. But theta, if you have two vectors, if you have two vectors A and B and you want to take its cross product and there is no value of theta, no angle value is given, then how can you take its cross product and how can you take its cross product magnitude? Okay, there are two things. This answer will be in vector form, in IJK form, and this answer will be in magnitude form, in scalar form. Remember this. But now the question is this: if we have two vectors, then how will you take its cross product? then I am telling about a method which you can use in this situation. And what is it? Let we have two vectors A and B. Okay? By a question you can learn this thing easily. Suppose vector A value is 4i plus 3j. Vector B is minus 3i cap plus 6j cap. Okay? Now, take its cross product. Take its cross product first. After that, we can take its magnitude also. Now, how can you take its cross product? Firstly, you have to write ijk in this way. Now, A cross B is this. Now take first value. Firstly, A value.